here, the wet weather has driven us inside, so we're at Guildford Guildhall on the High Street. The Royal Surrey Hospital here in Guildford has come out top in a recent PLACE inspection. PLACE stands for Patient-Led Assessments of the Care Environment. PLACE assesses the quality of the patient environment in hospitals, hospices and daycare treatment centres providing NHS-funded care. The Royal Surrey has made significant improvements and the new status has been attributed to the great work of all the teams at the hospital. Alf Turner, the Director of Organisational Transformation, said, "We are really proud of these fantastic results. I'm delighted that the hard work of the staff at the hospital has paid off." The Royal Surrey Hospital is now one of the best performing NHS hospitals and everyone at the site is keen to maintain and improve this position even further. A big thank you from everyone at Guildford TV and in the local area, I imagine, for making our town's hospital one of the best in the country. So I'm in the Guildford Guildhall today and I'm joined by Judge Stuart Wingate. Not quite, but you're in the judge's chair today.
I am indeed.
So can you give us a brief history of the court, the Guildhall in general?
Okay, well there's always been a building on this site since about 1300s. It's also had a role as a fire station and upstairs was converted in the late 1800s to become a council chamber.
So there's a lot of history here, so really a landmark of Guildford, and it's open to the public now?
It is. It's open 7 days a week throughout August, and then every Sunday from 11 a.m. throughout September. It's the first year we've actually opened the Guildhall to members of the public, and it gets the opportunity to come in and really experience a piece of Guildford's history.
Brilliant. So people in town, they should just pop in, have a look, and it's a beautiful place as well.
It is. I mean, it's one of the most photographed buildings in Guildford at all. Yeah, just literally pop in, come and experience the history for yourself.
Amazing, thank you so much for talking to us, it's been a pleasure. So I have found somebody in the witness box. Is it the accused Diana Roberts?
Hello there, Rebecca. No, this is definitely the witness box, okay. And I do promise to tell you the whole truth and nothing but the truth.
We haven't
today.
Got a Bible.
We haven't got a Bible, no, but we have got a town guide's flyer, okay. Which will do just as well. That will work. We've still got quite a lot of town guide's walks coming up, right through till the end of October. So if you're in town at any time, you can meet them under Tunsgate Arch, pick up a leaflet from the tourist office to give you the times. But what we've got now is if you can't get here at those appointed times, you can give yourself a lovely guided walk of the town. If you've got an Android phone or an iPhone, you download Handheld Tours and look for Guildford Historic Trail. And it will tell you exactly where you are, and it tells you, there's little bits to click on that will tell you about the place.
So it comes up with information.
So it'll tell you all about the Guildhall, about the castle, about Guildford House, and all the other high spots of the town. So instead of just having a wander around and, you know, do go in the cafes and go in the shops, but you can learn about the buildings that you're
so
in
you
and
don't
their history.
Need to be tied down to a timetable. You can just do it yourself
anytime.
No, not
at all. You can stop and have a drink and go in the shops.
At your own pace.
We'd go in the shops. Yeah. Absolutely. We'd be going
might
in the
just
shops.
Go in the shops.
And you can just go all the way around town. If you did it straight off, it's about an hour and a quarter. But it's best to just take it at your leisure, and you've got your phone there, and you can stop and start and go off into the side streets, get something to eat.
Okay,
and
then so it's an exciting new way to look around the town.
Yes, and at any time, even in the evening.
Brilliant. So they download from?
They download either Google or iPhone, Handheld Tours, and then look for Guildford Historic Trail.
So that's Handheld Tours.
Guildford Historic Trail.
Fantastic. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Get on that. Download it. Kickback Comedy returns to the Boiler Room on the 5th of September after their summer break. Hosted by the wonderful Deborah Jane Appleby, the show for the 5th of September includes Benjamin Crellin, with more acts to be confirmed after we film this. Visit kickbackcomedy.com for the latest updates. The show on the 5th begins a little earlier at 7 p.m, so be sure to arrive at the Boiler Room early. If you're looking to dine as well as laugh, the Boiler Room has a new offering in its Prime Minister options, served with mash and gravy. Yum yum! So I'm here in the Yvonne Arnaud Theatre and I'm joined by James Barber, director.
Good morning.
Good morning, how are you doing?
Very well, how are
good.
You?
Good, I'm pleased to hear it. So we're talking about the 50th anniversary of the theatre. So what's going on? What celebrations are you having for that event?
What's going on? We're celebrating 50 years. 50 years ago, This theatre opened in June, just passed, and it was an extraordinary achievement for the time because it was built by local people. They raised all the money, and the local authority, Guildford Borough Council, gave the land. And they built this theatre for about roughly £350,000. To build it now would be about £34 million. So it's a fairly amazing thing, and that takes some celebrating.
Definitely. So it's a landmark of Guildford, really. So,
yeah, I suppose it is now, actually.
Yeah, very established.
Yeah.
So what events have you got going on to celebrate it?
We've got a season, which is that, which you have, which is full of all kinds of things.
Yeah.
Opera, ballet, we're streaming stuff. We've got a pantomime, which has already sold a huge number of tickets. We've got some terrific plays, comedies, dramas, new plays, revivals, all that kind of stuff. So
a lot of entertainment.
We're very excited.
A lot of variety as well.
Yeah, yeah. Right now we've got two shows in Edinburgh at the festival. Our youth theatre's taken two new plays up there. They're performing probably about now, actually.
Fantastic.
They're there for 3 weeks. 20 young people from around here gone up and they're having the experience of their lives, I hope.
Yeah, so people should get down here, have a look at the events, and then can they get this booklet?
It's free, it's there,
or
you can ring up and ask for it, or you can email us.
Because the amount of stuff in here is amazing.
Yeah, that's why it's difficult to kind of pull it all out, you know, but yes, it's a huge array of stuff which takes us through to the sort of middle end of January.
Fantastic.
So we're very excited about it.
Yeah, so everyone come down, get this booklet. It's got a ton of stuff in it and it all looks very exciting. Celebrate the 50th anniversary.
Great.
Amazing. Thank you so much for talking to us.
Pleasure. Thank you.
I'm here on the Guildhall balcony with the band called Traffic Experiment. Tell me about that.
Well, the name, it comes from, it was actually a road sign I saw in Guildford, which
kind of
amused
original.
Me, absolutely, which kind of struck me as a bit of an unusual sign, because I don't know who would be experimenting with traffic, but I quite liked it as a name, so when we formed the band, we decided to call it that.
Oh, okay. So tell me about the band, tell me about the music.
It's sort of progressively art rock music, so it's quite extended pieces of music, and it's quite kind of in-depth, and it's a little bit arty, mildly pretentious, but you know, we kind of like it, so.
Yeah, so. Okay. And Simon, tell me about your band, SJW.
Yeah, well, SJW isn't nearly as interesting as Traffic Experiment. It's simply my initials, but I've written and recorded my own albums as well. So on the evening of the 5th, I'll be playing with my band, and then later on I'll be playing with Traffic Experiment as well. So I've got a busy
double
evening
shift,
ahead of me.
Double shift. Yeah.
Okay, and that's at the Electric Theatre.
Electric
in
Theatre,
Guildford.
Yeah, that's right.
Okay,
yes.
So how do people find out about your music?
Basically, if you go to www.trafficexperiment.net,
okay.
You can find all the information on there. The gig details are all on the Electric Theatre's website as well. So if you Google for Electric Theatre in Guildford, the box office there will have all the details.
Okay,
for
great.
Tickets.
So that's the 5th of September.
5th of September,
at the Electric Theatre. Check them out.
Main Chance Sanctuary is holding their big summer open day this Sunday, the 30th of August. The sanctuary, owned by actress Jenny Seagrove, rescues and rehabilitates abused, abandoned and old horses. On Sunday 30th, they'll be providing fun for all the family with tours of the park, stalls, food, drink and of course the beautiful horses. The gates open at 12 p.m. and the last tour starts at 3:30 p.m. To purchase tickets for this event, you can either email the sanctuary at office@mainchancesanctuary.org. And that's Maine as in a horse's mane, or you can call them on 07512 363 400. It's finally Wings on Wheels weekend. Access to the show by bus can now be achieved thanks to Compass Travel Bus Company. Compass will be running a special bus service over the weekend from Guildford Station to Dunsfold Aerodrome for Wings on Wheels 2015. The service will operate on both Saturday and Sunday. The buses will be waiting for passengers outside the station at 8:30, 9:30, 10:30 and 11:30, with return trips at 4, 5, 6 and 7 p.m. on both days. All profits from the bus service are being donated to Help for Heroes, a charity that gives direct help and support to our service men and women returning from battle zones. Tickets for the show are best purchased at the Guildford Tourist Information Office at this short notice, or via the website at wingsandwheels.net. There'll be lots happening at the show again this year. Have a look at our episode from last week to hear about some of the highlights you can expect from this year's show. We'll be there with the cameras, so do come and say hello if you see us filming around and seeing all the various activities that go on at Dunsfold Aerodrome this weekend. So as I mentioned last week, we're looking for new presenters to present positive news on Guildford TV. And I'm joined by Natalie, who did an interview for our episode this week. Did you enjoy yourself?
Yeah, it was exciting. A little bit nerve-wracking, but it's good to be here.
Yeah, it gets easier as you go along, trust me. So if you'd like to do some interviewing, some reporting, please get in touch on either Twitter or Facebook at The Surrey TV. Let us know if you want to get involved. As always, have a great weekend. If you're going to Wings and Wheels, have fun. Until next week.